Hey everybody, we are here today with Johnny Lee for Digital Rodeo. Johnny's got a great new project out that he's been working on, and I'm excited to have him tell us a little bit about it.
Well, somebody asked me, the reason I did a new CD, because all the old ones have already been done. They asked me, was the new CD going to be any good? I said, no. You know, I thought I'd try to do a piece of crap this time. Let's see how that works out. But it's the first CD I've had out in about 10 years. It's just time. You know, I'm appreciative and thankful for my hits, and I still do all I can do at the show, but I've got some new songs out that I'm doing, and I figured it was just time to do some new music, you know.
Absolutely.
And so I produced it along with my friend Buddy Hyatt in the studio, and we didn't bring any outsiders in. I know what I wanted, and he knew what I was communicating with him with, and I'm really proud of it. It's called You Ain't Never Been to Texas.
Yep.
And it's got a warning sign on the cover of the CD. It says, warning, real country music inside.
Well, and we're ready for real country music, that's for
sure. I played the CD for one of these new young country artists. They said, what's that sound? I said, it's a fiddle, you dumbass.
So did you write all the songs, or did you collaborate? Talk
no,
about
I collaborated.
That.
I wrote one of them, called I Wish I Could Love That Way Again, mm-hmm. for... my first puppy love I met when I was 12 years old at church camp. I promised her one day I'd write her a song. It took a few years, but...
just one or two. Yeah.
I'm still friends with her, though.
That's awesome.
And I collaborated on some of the songs and just wanted... I wanted to do some really hardcore country music, mm-hmm. that you don't get to hear a lot of anymore, with twin fiddles and steel guitars and stuff, you know. So, my God, that's just what we did.
That's it.
And one of the songs on there is an old Ray Price song called You're the Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me. Mm-hmm. That song came about, Terry Choate asked me after Ray Price passed away, when we was doing a TV show, a tribute to him, would I sing that song? I said, man, I totally forgot about that song. I used to sing it at Gilly's. So. Just a great song. And I'm getting ready to do a new book. And the first caption is going to be, when my life flashes before my eyes, it'll be worth watching. Worth Watching is one of my favorite songs on there. It's an original song. And Who Did You Love? And I covered the old Michael Martin Murphy, mm-hmm. song, What's Forever For? I always love that song.
I did too.
And
absolutely.
There's a real funky one. This girl showed up at my concert last Saturday night and said, touching, hugging, shoulder rubbing, sweet as apple pie. That's a line in my song called I Need a Good Loving Woman Bad. There's a lot of great songs in there. I redid an old Bob Wills song, Deep Water. And my daughter is on there with me. She's the one going, water. They said, we're not going to leave it in there. I said, heck yeah, I'm going to leave it in there. Why not?
That's
it's
right.
My CD. So.
That's right. Do what you want to
yeah,
do.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
That's awesome. So how many tour dates are you doing right now?
A little over 100.
That's awesome.
And are you out something.
By yourself? Are you out with other people? What are
both,
you doing? A little
both,
bit of both?
I do most of the dates are by myself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Last couple of years touring with Mickey Gilly from different, I say touring with different,
sure.
different jobs, you know. But every one of them has been sold out, but one, it almost sold out. So.
And it should be.
Yeah,
you've got an amazing.
There's not that many of us left.
But the songs will live forever. That's the good thing. Thank goodness.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
I pulled this little 12-year-old girl up out of the crowd the other night. I was singing in Hitchcock, Texas at the Galveston County Fair. And she knew every word, every song I was singing. I said, kid, how do you know that stuff? She said, my mom and daddy raised me on you.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the night when I was getting ready to do Looking for Love, she was looking up like a puppy wanting a drink of water. I pulled her up out of the crowd. She sang with me. She wasn't even born then.
Oh.
So to have a song with that kind of magnitude that kids still
absolutely.
Love.
Absolutely. Yeah.
It's pretty powerful stuff.
It is. Have you seen generations come through, like when you have your meet and greets and so forth? That,
yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
One of the first things, first time I ever got a grasp of that, I was in, I think, Biloxi, Mississippi, where Patty Ryan and Wanda Millett wrote the lyrics for that song, Live. They got the idea from a classroom of second grade children. And I signed autographs at the end of the show at this casino, played at. There was this group of people there together, four or five people. They said, we were in that second grade class. I said, wow.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Whew.
Wow.
That really hit home with
me. Oh, yeah. I bet it did.
And you were second grade, now you're old enough to come in here. Boy, time, where's time gone?
Because you're still 29, right? I mean, that.
I think I am. My head thinks, my mouth and my head and my heart think I am. But
oh, I'm right there with you. I hear you. Well, talk about your book a little bit. Are some of these stories in the book as well?
Well, we're just starting the book.
Okay.
The first, Scott England's going to be the writer. I'm going to tell him the stories. He's going to put them in book form, in my words. The way the book's going to start out, it says, when my life flashes before my eyes, it'll be worth watching. And my daughter, who got married last December, just told me she's pregnant. I'm going to be a grandfather. Mm-hmm. So I asked her if it was hers. And so the first thing you're going to see in the book is a picture of me holding my grandchild. It's going to be born in October. The book will probably be almost, or if not completed by then, but going to start back from my childhood. And I was going to wait until Mickey Gilly died before I put the book out so he couldn't afford another divorce. But I said, Gilly, I'm going to go ahead and do the book. He said, do it, good. So there's going to be some fun stories in there, you know, not anything.
Yeah, nothing too revealing, but just some good old stories.
Well, if it is revealing, by God, I'll just change some names.
There you go.
To protect the guilty.
There you go. I love the books that are like that, and he does a great job of writing and telling the story.
I met with him yesterday, and we had a long visit, and I actually met him when he was 19, and his wife was 15. Then now he showed me a picture of his 15-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
And showed me them pictures of back then when she was only four and I gave her a guitar pick and stuff. And it's just, wow, the way life comes back around. It'll bite you in the butt if you're not careful. I love it.
Certainly will. Certainly will. Well, as you were writing the songs for the project that you've got out, were any of them very personal? Did you dig deep and sing some personal stuff?
Yeah. Wish that I could love that way again. About my first puppy love.
Uh-huh.
It was more than just a puppy love, but first true love of my life. I met her when I was, like to listen to the song at the end, so I was just 12 and you were 10.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
I promised her, I don't remember much about her. Her name was Janice Smith, lived at 1026 Laurel Street, phone number WE53175. and we're still friends to this day.
Yeah.
Took quite a few years, but I got a great song out of her.
Yeah. Yeah.
All songs have a lot of meaning to me.
Mm-hmm. Are you the kind of person when a song comes to you, it just comes to you right away, or you mull over it for a while? Or,
both.
Yeah, a little bit of everything?
Both, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I wish they would just come to me so I could just write it down and get it over with.
Mm-hmm.
But the ones I mull over seem to be, they don't leave my head. You know, I still got songs in my
mind. Just live in there until,
tried to start 10, 15 years ago. I still think it'd be a good idea, but it just isn't time yet.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes you just have to wait for that right moment, that's for sure.
You got no choice.
Yep. Well, talk about, I mean, since you've been around for a while and you've seen the transitions from, you know, vinyl LPs and 8-tracks, and now everything is digital and everything is social media. How has that impacted what you do and how you reach the fans and how they have access to you, whereas years ago, they didn't have that same access as easily? So has there been any crazy stories, or has there been anything that, you know?
Well, number one, I adore my fans. I'm so fortunate to have fans to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
My ex-son-in-law does my media, so I'm a computer idiot. But I can get on my phone. He showed me how to get on my phone and on my Facebook stuff, you know. I answer people, sometimes they write back, God, I can't believe you answered me personally. That's the way I am, you know.
Yeah.
It's changed. When they first said, we're going to come out with these little things called CDs, that's going to work.
Right, you know? I remember that.
But now vinyl is coming back.
It is, and I'm so excited. I'm glad that it is.
I wish some reel-to-reels would come back. I got a whole garage full of things I never did sell.
Oh, man.
But, you know, in fact, I'd like to find some place to get me to make me some more Looking for Love albums.
Mm-hmm.
People want that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But the social media and stuff, I think it's great, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I don't know how to set that stuff up.
Right.
But there are people around me that do. And I'm not against learning, but I like think about other things.
Yeah. So other than the traditional touring and actually just going out and singing and the social media aspect of it, have you done anything else that's kind of like out of the box, something that's just different to really let the new generations know about your music?
Just the social media stuff. I started making some videos, putting them on my Facebook stuff. I just did the videos. I don't even know how to add them on there. Like I said, my ex-son-in-law does that.
So. Sure. Well, thank God we have people that know how to do it for us, right?
Oh, yeah, well, you know.
And it changes every day. There's something new every day.
If that was something we were learning growing up, that'd be something that I would know. That came along later, and like something I don't particularly care to spend a lot of time trying. I don't even know what a gigabyte is.
Yeah, yeah.
A gigabyte, that's going to be like at a concert, somebody bit me on the arm or something. I don't know.
Yeah. So as a new artist, I always ask all the new artists, you know, what's that golden ring for you? What's your pinnacle that you're reaching for? Is it an award or a performance on the Opry or what is it? How about you? Where are you at in your life? What's the big thing that you really want to happen yet?
I want to become a member of the Grand Ole Opry.
And we would love to see that happen. Absolutely.
That's been my goal. And to be accepted in the country music family.
Yep, that would be very awesome for everybody.
I'm going to record and sing and perform till the day I die. Anyway.
How many times have you played the Opry?
I don't know how many times it is, but it's been quite a few. Tonight I'm doing it, and my daughter's doing it with me.
Okay.
For the first time, she's going to do Yellow Rose of Texas and Cherokee Fiddle with me. And I'm going to do Looking for Love. Quite a few times. I go on there now, I still am honored and thrilled to get to do the Opry.
Mm-hmm.
I don't get butterflies like I used to. I go out there with a lot more confidence now, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But like my daughter tonight's her first time, so she's all like freaking out and going to a stylist and getting her hair done and doing this and doing that. She's totally freaking out. I said, baby, don't go out there and try to overdo it. Just go out there and be yourself.
That's exactly right. It's so laid back and comfortable and easy. And I recently had the opportunity to take some friends and take them backstage and to watch them see it through their eyes again. It's wonderful because it reminds us of our first time. And, you know,
well,
it is. It's a
magical
place.
The first time I ever went out there and walked in that step in that circle. Are you kidding me?
Yep. Yep.
Wow. What an honor.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not too many people can say they've done that.
No, absolutely not. It's definitely a big one. Well, I think that you'll get there. I really hope so. I do too.
I pray about that. So, you know, I'd love to be a member of the Grand Ole Opry.
Did we hear that? He wants to be a member of the Opry.
All you got to do is ask me.
That's right. So after you get this project done, I assume, are you going on radio tours and promotion and doing some of that kind of stuff?
Well, or? I do over 100 dates a year. I've been doing that for the last few years. So every time I go out, I'm promoting. You
right.
know? And I'll do another CD after this one, too.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know when that's going to be. I'm going to let it ride this horse till it gets winded first, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But that's what I do. I'm on tour all the time.
Well, that's good. We're glad to have you. So.
Thank you.
I look forward to hearing more from you and getting my hands on this CD and looking forward to you becoming that Opry member someday.
Well, and people can go to johnnyleemusic.com, order a copy from my website, and I'll autograph it and send it to you myself.
Perfect.
Or I think it's on like, what can you go on, Amazon or iTunes, whatever.
Everywhere, yeah.
Whatever that stuff is called, you can do that, you know, the media stuff.
So. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for talking with us today, and we look forward to seeing you again very soon.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.